You need to be wearing fishing waders to enter this stretch of river.
Don't stick your hands in.
Otherwise, you'll be electrocuted. These backpacks send electric waves into the water to temporarily stun these tiny, silvery brown, wriggling fish. This one may only be
72
millimeters long, but it plays a much bigger role in its ecosystem and in our water quality than you may realize.
You can't preserve and protect something that you don't understand.
It's a clear, sunny day in Zion National Park. The Virgin River snakes through the canyon, and within the walls of the orange sandstone cliffs, a dedicated crew of rangers and scientists from Zion National Park and the Utah Division of Wildlife Resources is in fishing waders, making their way down to the sandy and green banks of the water.
You know, if you care about these little fish like we do, we love to get in the river and see these fish and see that they're doing well.
Upstream and downstream, iron rods hammered into the riverbed. A green mesh wraps around the rods and stretches from one side of the Virgin River to the other. And large rocks are placed on top of the mesh in the river to steady the net. That's when the electrofisher comes in, a backpack that's fitted to send an electric charge through conductive materials like water, and the crew if they're not wearing protective gear. But don't worry, the fish are fine. They're just shocked enough to freeze them for a minute or two.
That charge stuns the fish. It doesn't hurt them other than stunning them. And they basically fall asleep.
This makes it much easier to scoop up the fish into buckets and to catch them with the large net downstream. Once collected, the net is then taken out of the water to collect the fish. The net catches some other critters too, like this tiny frog and this pinchy crawly thing, but the fish are the real prize.
Spec 45?
They need to be counted and measured. The process is then repeated two or three times to make sure they get all the fish they can. There are two main types of fish to see. Minnows, such as the Virgin Spine Dace,
Spine 63,
which is only found in Zion and the Speckled Dace, and suckers, such as a desert sucker and a flannel mouth sucker. Fish size matters in the Virgin River. It indicates the river's health, but not in the way that you may think.
What we want to see is diversity in age class. And so the measurement is essentially its particular age, the fish. We want to see fish that are very young. That means that we are reproducing within the system. But we also want to see older fish within the system as well to know that we do have reproducers that are producing that population.
Native fish are an important part of Zion's ecosystem. The fish eat bugs and algae in the river and in turn are eaten by birds, coyotes, and foxes. Monitoring the health of the Virgin's native fish population gives scientists an idea of the overall ecosystem health. Over 30 years ago, Virgin Spine Dace were on the brink of being endangered, which jeopardized the health of the environment. So multiple agencies got together to get to work.
Collaborative relationships really help us solve problems.
Over 20 years ago, several federal, state, and local entities, including the NPS and DWR, came together in a cooperative partnership to monitor and protect the fish and their habitat through the Virgin River Program. It not only protects this land, it protects our water systems.
But in order to keep that water clean, healthy, we have this thing called biodiversity, keeping everything in balance. And if we lose certain fish or certain insects or certain plants that are in the river, that really can lessen the water quality, which can affect humans in general.
And by wading in the water, catching the fish and counting and measuring them, we can look back at 31 years of data we've collected and see that today, things are looking good.
The small little pocket that we did today looks like it's healthy and the fish are doing well.
And that's thanks to collaboration, going through what some may call a shocking process, year after year, checking on these tiny fish to look at a much larger picture.
all of this work couldn't have happened if it wasn't for the Virgin River program to bring us all together.